In this video, I'm going to show you how to create this St. Patrick's Shamrock design all in Affinity Designer. Let's go!
Thanks for joining me on this video. My name is Juna with Detour Shirts, the channel all about helping you design and sell t-shirts online. If that's something you'd like to do, don't forget to hit that subscribe button right here. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to make this clover design for St. Patrick's Day. So there's a lot to it. So first I'm going to show you how to create a shamrock using the heart tool and the pen tool. And we're going to make that in Affinity Designer. Next, I'm going to show you how to make a pattern that goes inside of the shamrock. It's a real simple process there. And then I'm going to show you how to mask the pattern inside of the shamrock. So you have that nice pattern inside, as well as the outline around the shamrock and the text on top of it with that drop shadow. So you're going to want to stay till the end to see all of that. I'm going to show you how to do each one of those step by step, and it's going to be a nice quick tutorial for you to learn how to use some of those things in Affinity Designer. And if you stay till the end, you'll also see another addition of trend credits. So let's get started with Affinity Designer. So here we are in Affinity Designer. This is what we're going to do. I have my colors set to CMYK. I have three artboards here. They're all set at 4,500 by 5,400, which is the size for merch by Amazon. And we're just gonna start here. This is the final product that I'm gonna shoot for. It may not look exactly like this because we're gonna do it from scratch, but let's go for it. So I'm gonna zoom in here. The first thing I'm gonna do to create the shamrock is to use this heart tool right here, heart tool. And usually yours might say triangle tool, it's at the top, but if you scroll down, you can see heart tool is at the bottom. So just make a heart here, and you want just the fill, not the stroke. So I like it a little taller than wider. So just right there. So the next thing I'm gonna do is hit Option Shift and drag so I can copy it. And I'm gonna make this one, I'm going to this transform palette and turn it negative 98 degrees, like that. And I'm going to place that right on the tip. So these two tips touch each other, boom. And then I'm going to copy this again, Option Shift drag, and then flip it. You can see here, flip horizontal. And I'm going to make sure this tip also reaches is that one. So they're all touching each other. You can see all the three tips there are touching each other. The next thing I want to do is draw a stem. So I'm going to use the pen tool for that. And I'm just going to click here, pen tool, click up here. Then kind of about halfway, I'm going to do this with the Bezier curve. You can see this makes a curve. I just can drag it longer or taller just to kind of make that curve a little more bendy, I guess, more curved. And then click down here and I'm gonna hold down the shift so I can make a straight path here. I'm going a little wider at the bottom. I'm gonna click here again and kind of bend it back this way. And then back here, click and click to close it out. So you can see if I drag this out and make it black here, you can see it's shorter at the top or narrower at the top and wider at the bottom. And I can go back in here and fix these things. You know, maybe I want it curved like this and maybe curve this down like that. And maybe even move this here like that, right? And then once I get that stem, I'm gonna put the stem in here. Boom. That seems to work. If you want the stem bigger, just hold down shift. Whatever you want, kind of just eyeballing it here, right? Eyeballing it there. This one's kind of taller. I made it taller. So, you know, you can make it taller if you want. Easy, right? So that's how you do the shamrock. Super simple. And once you're done, select all of them and group them together by using this add at the top. And that's it. Now it's all one shape. So the next thing we want to do is create a pattern. So I'm going to go on the next artboard here and create a pattern. So the first thing I want to do is draw a square. So I click on here for the rectangle tool, click on that, and make sure to hold down shift while you drag. So I'm holding down shift and dragging. You can see the width and the height are the same size here. So just unclick that. I'm going to move this square about to the middle of the page, maybe a little more to the right. And I'm going to zoom in and just do the stroke of it. But I'm only going to use this for guide. So I'm going to make this stroke really thin there. And then the next thing I'm going to do is click the pen tool, click outside of the box here, hold down shift so that you can make a 45 degree angle and click outside the box. So this is kind of what I'm going for. And that's that. So take this and move it, holding down shift, kind of drag it to this corner here, like that. And I'm going to duplicate this 20 times. So the way you can do that really easy is hold down option, shift, drag. And once you hit one, then hit option J to duplicate that. So 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. That was by hitting option J 20 times or 19 times, I guess. And then drag this last one all the way to the corner. To the corner of this one right here. And we want to evenly space these out. So I'm going to back up, select all of these, not the square though, and then click on this, align horizontally, but we're going to space horizontally. So this right here, so you can see it's all spaced out correctly. Select all of those again, not the square again. And then I want to increase that stroke to be a little fatter so you can see. And I want that white space in between the strokes to be similar in size to the black space. So you can kind of eyeball it. There's no like real number, but like that's fine. And then I'm going to go to layer and convert these expand stroke. And then I'm going to combine all of these together, add, right? So now they're all one piece. You can see all one piece, all right? And just make sure that it's in that right space. And we're going to take that square again, move it to the top, back out here, and then select both and do intersect. So you can see intersect right here. And look what it does. It does this cool pattern right here. And we're going to use that twice. We're going to need a copy of this. So I'm going to hold down option, shift, and drag it diagonally so that those two corners touch. So you can see right there. After I get those two, I want to make two more squares. So the first square is going to be the same size as both of these. So click on here again, hold down shift. This time I want the square to be a different color. So let me just do like a light gray so you can see it. I'm going to put it behind so you can see that it's the same size. So same height here. I'm going to drag this to the left. Whoops. Then I'm going to make sure that these all touch each other. So that's there. This one, perfect. Move this one just a little bit. So you can see here, they're all touching the corner. Oh, this one right there. Okay. And then the next one I'm going to want to do is a bigger square. So I'm going to go Command C, copy, Command V. So you can see in my layers palette, I have it. This rectangle here, let me just close this. So you can see this one is in the back. So take that one in the back and drag it, holding down shift, and make sure that it's covering everything there. So now this is the basis for our pattern. So make sure we got the right color. So this gray, I'm going to turn it to green. 100% cyan, 0 magenta, 100 yellow, 0 K. And this one will be 100 everything. And these diagonal lines will be 100 everything. So let's make sure we select both of those. 100 CMYK. And there you have it. So that's the basis for our pattern. And let's just combine all of these. I'm going to group them. And I'm going to make them smaller. So we're going to do small, like about there. And what we're going to do is we're going to repeat this pattern. So we're going to repeat it horizontally and vertically. So let's start here. We'll zoom in. And I'm going to hold down Option Shift again until I get it right where I want it, right there. And then duplicate that. Remember, Command J. I'm going to do it several times. So when we back out here, you can see all of these are ready to go. And then the next thing I'm going to do is duplicate it vertically. So Option Shift again, right about there. And then Command J, Command J, Command J, right? So there you go. That's how you do a really quick pattern. And then I'm going to take my shamrock, put my shamrock on top of the pattern here. And we don't need the whole pattern. So I Command J'd it a few times, but we don't need all of those, right? That's going to work. And then, so all we need to do is group all of these minus the shamrock, of course. So let's group all of that. And let's make sure that the group, this group is at the top. And then you can see right here on my layers palette, I have the pattern on the top and the object below it. So to mask it, it's really easy is you drag it and then bring it to the right. So you'll see right there, you see right there, and it's inside of it. It's that simple. And you can see, you can move the mask around if you want this to be like in the center. That's great. And to the top. And that's it. That's how you make a mask of the pattern inside the shamrock. Whoops. So I'm going to grab this whole thing. Now, this whole thing is one thing, this curve. And I can move it around. And I'm going to put an outline behind it just in case you want to put it on a white background. You can see it better, or a black background. So that's really easy. Just copy Command V here. So this one on the bottom, I'm going to give it a stroke. That's it. And you can make the stroke as big as you want. Boom. Easy. The next thing I'm going to do is type some text. So text tool, click on here, type in lucky. So it's got to be the right color. So I'm going to click on it and make it white. And I want the uppercase L, so uppercase L here. And let's make sure it fits. So yeah, that's kind of, I'm going to tilt it just a little bit. There you go. So lucky. And then to give it the drop shadow, of course, I'm just going to copy and put it in the back. So you can see there's two luckies. This one is in the front. This one's the back. I'm going to make the back one black. And then I'm going to move it down with my arrow tool. Down and to the right. So you can see down and to the right. And that is it. Super simple, right? We did that in a few minutes. You can use this pattern on anything, any silhouette. Think about putting this on animals, on heart shapes, on diamond shapes, anything. And use it for different holidays, different occasions like that. So that was a super simple way to do it. Of course, it looks a little different than this one because I drew it a little different, but it still looks really great. And again, you can make it the pattern a different size, the shamrock a different shape, use different shapes, use a different font. I was using here Aerate Script. That's the font I used, but you can use any font you want. It doesn't have to be a script font. That is it for this video. Thanks so much for watching. Let me know in the comments if there's anything else you would like to learn how to design for St. Patrick's Day or any holiday that's coming up. I'd love to teach you how to design things in Affinity Designer. Let me know if this was really helpful for you as well. That is it for this video, and your reward for watching this video all the way to the end is another edition of Trend Credits. Thanks for staying till the end for this trend credits. Here is your trend. I'm here live. I'm not a cat. So this is from a meme, or actually from a Zoom call. You may have seen it in the news or on YouTube, where this lawyer is on a Zoom call and he has this cat filter. It's hilarious. You got to go see it if you haven't seen it on YouTube or wherever. But that's where this is coming from. It's something in pop culture that's made it to the news, and now it's just something that people want to buy on t-shirts for some reason. But here you go. It's getting lots of low BSRs here. So I guess people love cats, and it was a cute story, and it was really funny. So let's check Merch Informer. It's getting an A. If you don't have Merch Informer, I have a link in the description for Merch Informer. It's getting an A, so you know it's good. Very good competition here. Let's go back to the trend here. If you don't want to copy this trend, this is just an idea of something in pop culture that has become super popular. So just a reminder to look for those things in pop culture. Maybe something came up today, or something will come up in a few days that is super popular and you want to jump on it and make a t-shirt on it. You can see here, sometimes that works really well and can sell a lot of t-shirts. So if you want to do this one, I would suggest not to do this cat, because that's the cat that was used on there. So think of a different cat, or draw your own cat kind of thing, or maybe it doesn't even need to have a cat. So think of a different way for you to do yours so that yours stands out and is better than these. That is it for this video. Thanks so much for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. If this video gave you some value, give it a thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe. You can hit this subscribe button here in the bottom right corner to subscribe if you're not subscribed already. Thanks again for watching. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.